decided to become a builder because as a kid, I loved playing with Legos. And I knew at that time that I just had a passion for creating and building and problem solving. And realized that a great way I could translate my education was into the construction field. And I've loved it ever since. I love being able to drive by and, you know, point out and see what I've built that's added and contributed to the community.
And once I started to get involved with the technical and building side of the project, and I was able to walk outside and physically see the fruits of my labor, the reward of that is really what made me desire to become a builder.
There's a lot more women presence, and I'm excited for that because the more that it becomes a norm, the less it becomes a thing.
I've seen the women come a long way. I mean, there are a lot more younger girls choosing construction as their career.
I just remember many years ago when I was a PM having a scope meeting, and the PM from the other company at the table asked, where was the PM? Were they not able to make it? And I looked at him and said, I'm the PM for the project. I haven't gotten that too much more lately. And that's really just attributed to all the women out there who are, you know, buckled down, really learn their skill set, and are doing the work.
I love that we are becoming less unicorns and more the norm.
If I have to pick a proudest moment, I would say it's with my kids. When they look up to me and when they look at me working hard to make my dreams come true, and they are like, Mom, I want to be like you. It's one of the proud moments I have ever had.
Opportunities for folks in this industry are truly endless. You don't have to know day one where you want to be when you retire. It could be something that develops along the way that you kind of create your own path as you go.
There's so many elements that if you can find the thing that makes you passionate about showing up every day, there's just limitless opportunities to be able to be involved in what's creating our final product.
It's really an industry, an overall profession that you can choose your own adventure and make the most of it.
Some of the favorite things that I've built have been in the life science and healthcare sectors. It allows me to give back to my community in some ways. It makes me be part of a potential solution for cancer or for, other diseases that are out there.
My niece Gladys was born with spinal bifida. She has been in hospitals her entire life. Really wanted to build as many of these hospitals as I possibly could because it has done so much for my family and the care and the well-being that I wanted to make sure that other families got the experience, the positive experience that we have had with Gladys to date.
Construction can be a very demanding yet rewarding career, and sometimes a lot could be on the line. Working over an active hospital, sometimes what's on the line is someone's life.
For me, the most important thing is to have a mission or a vision for that facility that you can connect with, to understand why your client's purpose is greater than bricks and mortar, and see that come alive in any detail.
So I feel like beyond the standard traits that a person can obtain, I think that really in any role, if you have genuine love and enjoyment for what you do, that success is bound to follow you naturally.